George Cal Motor Company player of the game, number 44, Joe Brodus. Tell me about this belt, my friend. What is this belt?
An Alpha Dog belt is a belt that you win when you work hard.
Is that right? Show that
yes,
to the
sir.
Phone. Show the Alpha Dog belt. Fantastic, my friend.
I got to say one thing.
Yes,
if
sir.
If it wasn't for them llamas, like I said last year, I won't been nowhere tonight.
Offensive line, Joe, was outstanding. You know that.
Yes,
and
sir.
I think most of we saw that as a broadcast group. They were phenomenal, were they not?
Yes, sir, they was.
Tell us about your game. I know that you worked hard. You were spinning. You were fighting. And, I mean, tell us about winning the first one. You know, we lost the first one last year. And then, you know, it was really later on in the year before you became a force for the offense. But, man, you were a force for the offense tonight starting off, and we knew you would be. Congratulations on your game.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about the game.
Well, tonight, my mom said was coming out here and beat them because they beat us last year.
Right.
So, before we came out, we was talking about how we went to their town, they beat us. And we was going to let them come to our town and beat them like they did us last year.
Sure.
And we had a mindset to come out here and play every four quarters we had in us. So, one thing I got to say is we work hard every day in practice, and the offensive line, defensive line, linebackers, cornerbacks, they all do their job.
Hey, let me ask you this, Joe. As well as we did, you know, you ran the football as well as the offensive
yes,
line did. Talk about that defense out there. You know, four different times, and Coach Hines and I talked about it, four different times those guys had a fourth down situation, two of them inside the five, and we held them all four times. Talk a little bit about your defense.
Them defense is a hard fighting team we got. Them defense, you can put them anywhere in the middle of that field and they will take them down somehow. Them, most of them guys, they started last year. Some of them guys, they new to
sure.
our team and stuff.
Sure.
But most of them guys, they know what they're doing out there, like O'Shea Pruitt and Julius. Them some Bash brothers, for
yes,
real.
The
them
Bash,
some real guys.
The Bash brothers,
yes,
for
sir.
Sure, no doubt about it. Well, congratulations to you. It's a great start
yes,
for the
sir.
Hounds, a great start for the offense. It's great to be a Newport Greyhound. And before you get out here, and again, I talked to Coach Hines about this, what about that crowd over there tonight? Were they? Could you
I love it.
Yeah.
I just zone out, so I really don't hear them. But when I look in that stand, they're great.
No doubt
feel
about
good
it.
Seeing them guys in the stands.
It does. George Cal Motor Company, player of the game, number 44, Joe Brodus. Appreciate you, my friend.
Yes, sir.
Outstanding.
I got to say one more thing.
Yes, sir.
Thanks to the offensive line tonight. If it weren't for them, I wouldn't have been nowhere tonight. Same.
No doubt about
yes,
it.
Yes, sir.
Joe Brodus, number 44. Subway Coaches Report, Mark Hansley to talk about the big victory that we just saw. 15-8 over the Gosnell Pirates. Coach, welcome to the winning ways of the first football game of the year.
Oh, it feels good.
Is it not exciting?
It is exciting. And when you play that way, it's sweet. That's the only way to really talk about it. It's because you feel like you did a lot of things right. Now, we made some mistakes, and we're going to fix them. But we did so many things right tonight, and I'm just proud.
Hey, I want to talk, first of all, I want to talk about the offensive line.
Mm-hmm.
We give up a play. They get an 83-yard touchdown mm-hmm. run on third down and long. They just made a play. We were there. We mm-hmm. didn't make the play. They made one big play offensively mm-hmm. against our defense all night. But I want to talk offensive line first. We needed an answer. We needed an answer. And we took that football right back down. We drove down there. The offensive line took control. And it took us 2 minutes to score.
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about how it was over on the sidelines. We'd led 7-0. It's 7-0, 7-0, 7-0. And they get one play, and then all of a sudden they go for two, and we're down 8-7. What was the mindset there at that time?
You know what? Two things. In control.
Right.
And gritty. The what we talked about from the start of our football game is we want to be in control. We don't want them to for 1 second to be in control. You saw us do a lot of dead calls. We tried to make them
sure.
jump off this offsides. We would try to, you know, have long tried to have long extended drives just to let them know that we were in control. Control was a thing that I was preaching from the start of the game and halftime, and then I let them know that they were in control the whole ball game. So and then also grittiness. We talk about sudden change a lot. You know, and if something bad happens, like a turnover or a big play on defense, you gotta flip that switch and be a sudden change kind of offense or a defense, and you just gotta have a mindset of you still have to do your job. And I talk to especially the linemen all the time is mental and physical toughness equals grittiness. And if they had grittiness, and we talked about that before
sure.
about those offensive line,
sure.
and I'm telling you, and I told those guys, I right before I congratulated Joe Brodus down here on the field, I first told the O-line to to raise their hand because we didn't have a whole lot of, you know, we didn't, those guys went both ways almost the whole night.
We talked about it.
And they still were just that push that we hadn't had and needed. And man, I was so proud of the offensive line and the grittiness and the push they showed tonight.
I want to talk defensively because, Coach, I'm going to tell you what. We were swarming the football mm-hmm. as well as we've swarmed it in many years. We did our job defensively. We did the things that we were supposed to do four different times during the game, two times inside the five-yard line. Those guys had fourth down, and we stopped them. We saw a lot of that last year. Yeah. It's just kind of – that becomes contagious.
It does.
And this group, where a lot of these guys played last year, a lot of them did. That's become contagious, but the defense obviously was magnificent.
Let me first and foremost – I have to thank the coaches because I brought this idea in how I wanted to shut down the double wing right after we got through with our Highland scrimmage. And they, you know, we had a general idea what the D-line had to do, linebackers had to do, secondary had to do. And they did a great job of selling that to the kids.
Right.
And the kids did a great job of doing that. And I talked about it in the coaches show earlier is that is an offense that works off of rhythmic plays.
Sure.
And timing. Okay, and then, you know, and that's what I told them is we wanted to take that away from them with how we pushed the, you know, defensive line, how they played, did an awesome job. And then secondly, they want to try to work off misdirection.
Right.
And, you know, and I told the kids, I said, if you try to watch the football, you'll be on the wrong side of the play.
Right, absolutely.
And I told them, I said, we're going to have these specific people that we watch because we watch film and they kind of give it away with certain players on what they did.
Right.
And we sold out to those reads. And, I mean, you can see here, it worked like
a
charm.
We were there.
I mean, and if it wasn't for 23, 23 is a big old boy, I have to admit.
Yeah.
And if it wasn't for just a few missed tackles right there, I mean, it would have been
we were there to make plays. Ball. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
so, man, I was proud of that defense. They come out sticking and doing exactly what we had to do, and I couldn't be happier for them.
Well, you know, you talk about it a lot. We talk about it as we progress through the season. You know, you had the first three mm-hmm. games, non-conference game, then you end of conference playoffs, blah, 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 blah. It's huge to win your first one. It's huge to win your first one. We played well last year.
I can't say it enough that is a great football team. They won their conference last
Absolutely
year.
Absolutely they
okay?
did.
Okay? And they're pretty high ranked up there behind Pocahontas to yep. win their conference again this year. And a lot of the people I talked to thought they would be. So to win that ball game and to start off 1-0 is big for our football team.
Well, I think it's big for our fans, and I wanted to ask you about this. And I know you get caught up in your calling signals, and you mm-hmm. don't most of the times you can't hear the fans.
Right.
But I know one time when we got a play coming over to y'all side over there, and I didn't have a headset on. I was just – and I listened to the crowd, and it was a roar. It
yeah.
was a deafening roar. And
yeah.
I thought
– I feel it. Yeah.
I thought, man, that's fantastic. Talk
that
a little bit about our Graham
well,
fans.
You know, and that's and I started feeling – you know, when we first walked out of the game, I was like, it's a pretty decent crowd. Well, then it just started growing and growing. And the feeling that I had when I got down on this end, the roar you're talking about, it was there. And when you're standing down there and you feel that roar behind you –
Yes.
Man, it's powerful.
It's a roar.
I'm telling you,
yes.
it's powerful. And it keeps you in the game as much, you know, we just feed off each other. You know, you always talk hearing about, you know, singers and stuff feeding off the crowd.
Sure.
We really do. And these kids really do feed off the crowd. They really do.
I do know this, and Randy Klepeczka was outstanding, you know, as
yeah.
PA and getting,
oh, yeah.
getting the folks on their feet, and he was magnificent there. And at the end of the first quarter, there was still a line of people trying to get into the football game.
Yeah.
So it was huge crowds, a vocal crowd, you know, we talked about it 2 years ago. We had help
yeah.
coming. We're gonna be better. We got
are.
Guys coming, and we got more help coming.
Yeah.
We got
well,
more.
And you know what's so great about it is I feel like we're being successful doing it the right way, David.
Absolutely.
I really do.
Absolutely.
I feel that way really deep down. And like I said, you know, just Joe Brodus, you know, just simple things like Stanley Lubman comes out of it. There's a good connection we got right now with these guys, and from the guys' standpoint on how, you know, how much we trust each other. You know, I talk about trust all the time and the trust that we have and the trust I have in the coaches and you know the best thing that happened all game to me, David, was that 9-minute drive we had, or however, what was that long
drive? Right
at the
end, yeah, when we took
that
off at fourth quarter.
Huge.
Yes, yes.
You know,
and
we talk about that on Thursdays all the time. And John Bradley did a great job
yep.
of keeping the football secure
right.
and keeping us in positive yardage plays and to work that football down like we did and try for the field goal.
Absolutely, yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
we tried to do everything the book said. And,
right.
I mean, that's just good football, and it was really exciting to watch.
Well, there's no doubt when you win, you feel better, your preparation. You know, that was talked about, you know, your most improvement comes from game one to game two, because that's really the time. I mean, you can go to the Highland and play in a scrimmage game, and it's close. It's a simulated game. But but when you really have to play four quarters like we did tonight, and then no doubt we'll go back to work. You guys will be back to work tomorrow morning. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Excited to be a Newport Greyhound.
I'm telling you.
I haven't been, you know, as much as involved as what I needed to be, but I'll get my eyes correct. So, you know, last time I tried to do a ball game, didn't have an eye. Now I lost one eye, but I can't see anything.
You're still here.
But, Hayden, I'm here. I'm above ground. I'm breathing. I'm loving my Newport Greyhounds.
That's right. David,
congratulations, my friend. Mark Hinesley, head football coach, athletic director of the Newport Greyhounds. His show each and every Friday night is brought to you by Subway in the Walmart Supercenter. The Greyhounds are number one tonight, winning 15-8. We're 1-0, and go Hounds.
Go Hounds.